So you're still determined to go to this town, Doctor? See? That's the kind of welcome you get in Kermigan. Death.
They sure don't make them like this anymore. Kill Baby Kill is an Italian gothic ghost story from 1966 by the mastermind that was Mario Bava. If you're not familiar with Mario Bava, then go and just watch every movie he's ever done. He's a brilliant filmmaker and perhaps even my favorite director of all time. He was so great, so influential, and so underappreciated while he was still alive. Kill Baby Kill, or its alternative titles Operation Fear, Curse of the Dead, Curse of the Living Dead, or Don't Walk in the Park, takes place in a small town in the late 19th century. Dr. Paul S.Y., played by Giacomo Rossi Stewart, who also showed up in two other Bava movies, Kaltiki, the Immortal Monster, and Knives of the Avenger, arrives at the village to perform an autopsy on a young lady who had died under mysterious circumstances. The local townsfolks are not too eager to talk about the death, which makes S.Y. consider the theory of a conspiracy being held in the small village. But he will soon find out that there is actually a curse of a young girl named Melissa haunting his place and seeking revenge upon the villagers who did her wrong when she was still alive. According to Bava himself, this little gothic flick was made in only 12 days. And in some ways, you can see it. The script is very basic and could have used some more work done to it. On the other hand, there is so much awesomeness in nearly every frame of the film. Bava is the master of creating colorful, stylish shots and is obviously having plenty of fun creating this film. It's almost like he's making love to the camera here. And I do wish that more modern filmmakers would be inspired by the way films like this used to look back in the day and try to give their own movies the same effort and eye for detail, as it just enhances everything so much more when a film looks as beautiful as Kill Baby Kill does. It's no wonder why this is considered to be one of his absolute best efforts by his hardcore fans. Previously mentioned Giacomo Rossi Stewart is perfectly cast as the hero Dr. S.Y. There isn't much else to do with this character than just look the part, and Giacomo looks perfect as a good guy in a film like this. The female characters aren't that fleshed out either, but the actresses all look great and do what they can with the little they have to work with. Now, one fun fact is that the little ghost girl is actually played by a young boy in a wig. This just adds some weirdness to her or him, and it was a good choice regardless of what was the reasoning behind it. There is also a good score here by composer Giacomo Rusticelli, but fans of Bava films will notice that he's using some stuff from Blood and Black Lace and The Whip and the Body here. It is still an eerie and great soundtrack though. This year is actually the 50th anniversary of Mario Bava's Kill Baby Kill. So what's better than to make sure that you revisit it in honor of this superb filmmaker? I'm not quite sure how modern audiences will view this film, but fans of Italian or gothic horror films should make sure they see this one. Kill Baby Kill is not one of my favorite Bava films, but it's a fine film and quite an achievement by him. So with that being said, my score for this film ends up being a 3.5 out of 5. So what are your favorite Bava movie? I keep changing mine from day to day, to be honest. Does Kill Baby Kill deserve the number one spot on a list like that? And what do you think of the film? And would you like me to review more Bava movies in the near future? If so, a like would be very appreciated, and subscribe for more reviews coming soon.